Now we would give, I would request our volunteers to give opportunity to any non-Muslim brothers and guests we have here at our mics to give them a preference and opportunity, and then our other brothers.
I am K. Mahesh, from lecturer from Sabo Siddiq Polytechnic in the Computer Department. I would like to ask regarding the Muslim marriage system, why Islam allows more than one woman to be married with a man?
The brother posed the question that why does Islam allow a man to marry more than one wife? Quran is the only religious book on the face of the earth which says marry only one. There's no other religious book on the face of the earth, whether you read the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, the Bhagavad Gita, the Bible, no religious book says marry only one except the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 3, it says, marry one of your choice in twos, threes, or fours. But if you can't do justice, marry only one. If you can't do justice, marry only one. Otherwise, if you can do justice, Quran has put an upper limit, two, three, or four. Maximum four, not more than that. Previous religions, they gave permission for a man to marry as many wives as you want. Quran put an upper restriction of maximum four. You know why? Because if you think logically, if you analyze, but it says at the same time, in Surah Nisa chapter 4, verse 129, it is difficult to do justice between your wives. It's difficult. Therefore, do not turn away from them altogether. Marrying more than one wife, you don't get more sawab. You don't get more blessings. There is no hadith saying that if you marry more than one wife, you get more sawab. There's a hadith which says that if you marry, you complete half your deen. Somebody asked me a question at the time, does it mean if I marry twice, I complete my full deen? No, marriage takes you away from promiscuity, from fornication, therefore it is farz. But whether you marry one or two, yet you're only completing half your deen. The reason why Islam gives permission for polygyny, that's the right word, is because if you analyze, men and women are born in equal proportion. But in the pediatric age itself, since the female is the stronger sex medically, if you ask any pediatrician, he'll tell you, the female can fight the germs and disease much better than the male. So more female children live than the male children. There are more deaths in the male children than female children. When you grow up, there are accidents, death due to cigarette smoking, death due to war. More male die than female. War in Afghanistan. Do you know more than 1 million people died? Mainly they were gents. Whatever it is, whatever you said. More men die than female. If you analyze the statistics, India is one of the few countries in which there is more male than female. You know why? Because of female infanticide. Every day, 3,000 fetuses are being aborted when they identified that they are females. More than 1 million aborted every year in India on being identified they are female. That's the reason. Otherwise, if you see the statistics of America, there are more than 7.8 million females than males in America alone. In New York alone, there is 1 million female more than male. And out of the population of New York, one-third are gay. Sodomite, Cameluth. There are more than 25 million gays in America. That means there are more than 30 million females who can't find husband in America alone. In UK alone, there are 4 million females more than male. In Germany alone, 5 million females more than male. In Russia alone, 7 million females more than male. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone knows there are how many million females more than males in this world. I am asking you a question that suppose my sister or your sister happens to live in America, and suppose everyone agrees with your philosophy that every man should marry one wife, and every man in America marries a woman, still there will be 7.8 million females, and plus, since the gays also don't get married, there will be more than 25 to 30 million females who can't find husbands. If my sister happens to be one of those unfortunate ladies who has not been married and the market is saturated, the only option remaining for my sister is to marry a man who already has a wife or become public property.